दबाई।
Is the screen visible?
So we can't hear you.
हेलो कैन यू हियर मी नीरज।
यस सर यू ऑडिबल नाउ।
ओके सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग विथ मॉड्यूल वन दैट इज इंडस्ट्रियल इंजीनियरिंग एंड प्रोडक्टिविटी। इन मॉड्यूल वन अगेन इट इज इन मॉड्यूल वन various topics are introduction to industrial engineering, then productivity, then method study, which deals with the method, then work measurement, that is basically time study, and 1.4 is job evaluation and wage test. So we are starting with 1.1, which is introduction to industrial engineering and productivity. Industrial engineering has a lot of scope, especially abroad as well as for higher education also. Most of the students, as I told yesterday, they opt for industrial engineering. And it is not too theoretical. And it is not exhaustively mathematical.
Hello.
Hello. It is not.
Sir, can you accept some students?
Yeah, that's why I was waiting for 5 minutes. Yeah, I think they are in. I think. They are in, no? So it is not too theoretical and it is not too mathematical also, like your analysis or structural analysis, Ranga Kutta method, knowledge of maths 1, maths 2, maths 3, maths 4, some subjects it is required. So here it is not so. So basically, industrial engineering, it is concerned with design, improvement and installation of integrated systems of people, materials, information, equipment and energy. So it integrates the employees, basically all the employees, right from the president to the sweeper. Okay, then it is integration of materials, then information, that is flow of information.
Sir, it can also you please accept people who are in the waiting room?
I accept it. Still there are some more. Nobody is there now in the waiting room. Equipment and energy. So information, that is most important. Information can be in the form of hard as well as in the form of soft also. That is, it can be digitized or it can be in terms of hard copy. Nowadays it is Industry 4 is nothing but mostly it is in the form of soft copy. Okay. Then it requires, you know, little knowledge of mathematics, I mean not too deep, and it is somewhat practical also, because you need to do the method study and time study. All right, so industrial engineers, they determine the most, this is what is important, it determines the most effective ways, you know, to use the 4M. The 4M is nothing but man, machine, materials and method. This is what you have to remember. So it is the optimum utilization of 4M. That is M4M, it stands for man, then machines, materials and methods. Okay, and nowadays you have to optimize the use of energy also, because it, if we are talking about non-renewable sources of energy, then we have limited stock, and renewable energy is not yet explored much, like, you know, tidal energy or hydro or your solar. This is still into the primitive stage. I mean, if you want to have 1000 kilowatt or 2000 kilowatt, it is still not possible. So this is what the broad areas of industrial engineering is. Like it can be applied for, it's not necessary that it should be applied for Mahindra and Mahindra, that is automobile industry or furniture industry or lock industry or foundry. It can be applied anywhere, you know, like manufacturing, finance, IT sector, supply chain, in education also, then in sales and in energy, everywhere it can be applied. That is, method study and time study is important. Like, suppose if you are doing any office work, you know, there is something called as a TPM. That is, TPM is not, again, it's a typical Viva question, what is the full form of TPM? So most of the students say that it is total predictive maintenance, but TPM is actually basically total productive manufacturing. Okay, so here the manufacturing should be productive, and TPM, not necessarily that it can be used on the workshop, but it can be used on the, or it is being used in the office also, because office efficiency also has to be increased. So there are methods, you know, which has to be adopted in office also. So that is called as a TPM office. So industrial engineering has footprints in every areas. So the typical focus, you know, areas, it includes your project management, then manufacturing, supply chain management. This is the same as the previous slots, previous slide which was shown just now. Then ergonomics, which is most important. And here industrial engineers plays, you know, very important role. Like if you talk about companies like Volvo, you know, or big MNCs in mostly automobile engineering, all Volkswagen, they have nearly, you know, 10 engineers, PG engineers, working only on ergonomics. 10 engineers only working on ergonomics. That is how you can provide the comfort, you know, to the employees who are doing the assemblies or who are doing the work. Like, so for example, if I give you example, like suppose if you want to fit the differential gearbox from the bottom, or if you want to fit the propeller shaft from the bottom, it is beneath the chassis. Okay, so how comfortably it can be fitted, you know, how comfortably it can be. The propeller shaft is a little inclined. Okay, so I have seen here that we have normally we have a pit, and in the pit the employees are sitting in a very, you know, uncomfortable manner, and at the end of the day, if he has to assemble say 300 vehicles, so that means 300 into 300 universal joints, the next day surely he is going to remain absent because of the severe back pain. Same thing like tire, you know, mounting of tire. So one tire per person. So if he has to lift the tire and place the tire, he has to align the tire. So if he's doing 300 tires, you know, assembly of 300 tires, then again next day he won't wake up. If it is ergonomically, if that particular workstation or if that particular work, like placing the tire, aligning the tire, and you know, fixing up the bolts and nut and tightening the tire with proper torque. If you don't have a proper method study or a proper ergonomically designed workstation, you know, the employees will suffer from the diseases. It will be uncomfortable, efficiency will be down, and absenteeism will increase. So ergonomics plays very important role in industrial engineering. Right? So even it can be applied for the finance also. So finance engineering also. So what is objectives of industrial engineering? Basically to increase the productivity, and productivity is nothing but the ratio of output upon input, output upon input. Okay, so more your numerator should increase and denominator should decrease, basically. But of course that is not true, otherwise efficiency would have been more than one, okay, or more than 100%. I'm not talking about reverse engineering like heat engines or refrigeration, where we talk about COP, that is coefficient of performance. Usually the efficiency is less than one or less than 100%, because output is not more than input. But we should try to approach that 100%, 99%, 90%, at least 70%. So productivity is with less and less input, you have to try more and more output, right? Cost reduction is another objective of industrial engineering, but of course not at cost reduction. It is not at the cost of quality or safety. You cannot compromise on quality. You cannot compromise on quality, or you cannot compromise on your safety. That is most important. That is quality. It increases or it improves your image of the company or the organization, and safety is of course the most important, because if it is not safe, if the environment, if the working environment is not safe, then obviously it is going to cause a lot of accidents or sickness of the workers, and absenteeism will increase, how many labors you are going to replace, and finally your production. Like suppose if the 50% of the employees are absent because of unsafe environment, then how you are going to give, how you are going to meet the target of say 300 vehicles in 8 hours? It will straight away come to 150. Even if you have you cannot have casual labors, or you cannot have labors in cushion, how many labors you will keep in spares or extra, because you have to bear the cost of the labor also. Fine. So the safety is most important, and cost reduction doesn't mean that you'll compromise on quality or in safety. Okay, so this again has been shown in the last slide, that is where are the application areas of industrial engineering. Whenever the question is asked, like say for 5 marks, discuss the application areas of industrial engineering, it is expected that you elaborate. For 5 marks, even if you write 5, you do not have to give all these, all this, but what is expected that you just write 5 applications, but at least write 4-5 lines, like in banking, how industrial engineering will be helpful. If you talk about say construction, how industrial engineering is going to be helpful. Like banking, people say that if you stand beyond this line, behind this line, or you will be out in this bank, maximum time that you will spend is 5 minutes. So on what basis? It is nothing but your method study or time study, isn't it? There is an appropriate method, window number 1, window number 2, window number 3. Like suppose if you go to railway counter, they will have more counters in the morning because that is peak area. They will have less counter in the afternoon. Again in the evening, there are more counters, there are more people. So this has been done, with the help of industrial engineering. They have studied it, method study, time study, PMTS, MOS, all these techniques has been used. So 5 marks question, what is expected that you have to elaborate at least 3-4 lines. Mining, how it is going. Simply writing mining, oil and gas for 5 marks will not give you. It will almost give you two, maximum 2 marks if you don't. If you don't elaborate, because you are into final year of engineering, it is not like 9th standard or 8th standard paper or examination. how in logistic industrial engineering techniques can be used. So here is the, you know, history in industrial engineering, and it all started with the automobile sector. Mostly all the industries, you know, were started due to the inventions in the automobile sectors, and that's why automobile sector is very important. So earlier it was, you know, labor oriented, like totally 100% manual. Like you can see the people's, you know, they are lifting the wheels here and they are placing it, aligning it, and then tightening it. So you can see whenever they are lifting it, they have to bend down. Okay, whenever they are placing it, again they have to bend. Okay, so there is a pressure on the knees, legs, back, you know, hands, everywhere. And like that, imagine, you know, there are one person, if the target is say 300 vehicles in a shift, and people are producing, like Mahindra Bolero, they are producing 300, maybe this is 2 years back figure, I'm not talking about lockdown. So imagine if it is not properly designed, and if it is strictly manually oriented, imagine how stressful it will be. And then that was your labor specialized. Okay, then scientific management, the people, you know, studied the assembly lines, the technology was evaluated, then semi-automation was started, and because of that it was improved, and then finally in most of the lines here you can see it is fully automated. And concept of lean production was introduced. Jurong, they worked a lot on this. Taylor, they worked a lot. And totally from manually to semi automation to the fully automation. Of course, I don't mean that all the lines has to be totally or fully automated. It depends upon the product and it depends upon the customer also. So if the line is totally fully automated, then definitely the cost is going to increase. Like suppose if you say that four wheels I have to, you know, place, and plus fifth wheel, that is stepney. So if you say that, sir, I will remove these four people or five people, and I will have a robo, pick and place kind of a robo, and I'll place the wheel, you know, then what will be the cost of the robo? And suppose if the cost of the robo is around say 20 lakhs, so definitely that will be borne by the product. So your product cost will increase. So if the line is designed for Bolero, and if it is a semi-automatic line, and if the Bolero is costing around 5 lakhs, and if you make it automated, totally automated, 20 lakhs, 25 lakhs, fine, everywhere, then it may 5 lakhs, it will become 7 lakhs. So who is going to purchase this? So obviously your demand will less. Okay. Yes, automated line, you know, semi-automated lines can work for, you know, like automobiles, like say Volkswagen. So fine, there the cost is say 13-14 lakhs. So the people, you can get the customers. So you have to have a trade-off between the product, customer, and the cost. You know, still, yeah, we prefer semi-automatic line. Like suppose, because say, why the semi-automatic line is preferred? So that we can improve the production. Okay, we can improve the production, and then the cost can come. Why? Because if we improve the production, like suppose you won't imagine, but in 90s, you know, the production of the Bolero was 40 per shift, 40 per shift, 40 numbers of Bolero, that too also very cut to cut. 40 Boleros in 8 hours of shift, so around 100 and 120 Boleros in three shifts. Now the same in 2018, the figure is 2018-19, the figure is 300 in a shift. 300 in a shift, so 40 to 300, almost eight times. It is not only because of the automation, it is also because of the human philosophy, human behavior, you know, human management, communication, then in your industrial relation, that also has played very important role. Earlier it was whip technology or cane technology. चाबुक लेके पीछे बैठते थे. देन यूनियन प्लेड मेजर रोल इन 90s. सो यूनियंस वेर स्ट्रॉन्ग, यू नो, मैनेजमेंट वॉज ड्रिवन बाय यूनियन. यू नो, यू माइट हैव हर्ड अबाउट टाटा सामंत एंड अदर यूनियंस. सो दैट टाइम वर्कर जो करे वो कायदा, जो यूनियन लीडर बोले वो कायदा, ऐसा दैट वॉज द सीन. ओके, बट स्लोली स्लोली बिकॉज ऑफ द सेमी ऑटोमेशन एंड ऑटोमेशन, यू नो, यूनियन लीडर्स, पीपल्स, एम्प्लॉइज, वर्कर्स ऑल्सो केम टू नो दैट सपोज इफ आई डोंट लिसन टू द मैनेजमेंट, इफ आई डोंट वर्क अकॉर्डिंग टू द नॉर्म्स, देन आई विल नॉट बी और आई वोंट बी नो मोर, आई वोंट बी नो मोर. सो आई हैव टू लिसन टू द. देन मल्टी स्किलिंग का जमाना आया, यू वोंट बिलीव, बट फर्स्ट initially the scene was, you know, the scene was like, suppose a person is drilling, okay, person is drilling on a drilling machine, he will only do drilling work, even he will not lift the, you won't believe, even he won't lift the workpiece which is kept down in a bin near to the drilling machine on the table. That is, he has to lift the workpiece and he has to place it on the table and do the drilling. So what he used to tell, wo to helper ka kaam hai, main to driller hu, I am IT, I will do drilling. So for him, the management or the production manager has to employ one more person only for loading and unloading the component, and this guy will only do the drilling, that's all. Even he will not do the drill grinding. Bolega drill grinding mere ko nahi aata properly. So there has to be one more person for doing the grinding of the tools, like that. But now it is changed. Now it is multi skilling. Now the person knows, you know, he knows that he has to keep his working environment clean and clear. So he doesn't mind even cleaning the machine. He doesn't mind even cleaning the surrounding. He doesn't mind, driller doesn't mind even working on lathe machine or milling machine, because he knows if he doesn't know multi-skilling, if he is not able to do many jobs, okay, tomorrow somebody is going to replace, he will be replaced by some other person. Okay, so that is how the evaluation is. And the very first in industrial engineering, or it cannot be started without taking the name of F.W. Taylor. There is one institute which is named as NITI, and it is at Powai. That is, if you come from RA Colony, you will see Morarji Nagar, and then you will see a pipeline. Okay, so just next to that pipeline, it is situated. That is NITI. It is only devoted for industrial engineering. So they have courses, master's courses and doctorate level courses in industrial engineering. Fine. That is in Mumbai. This institute is operational and it is very reputed. So even for doing the master's and PhD, you get very good scholarships. It is under the management of central government. It is driven by central government and not by state government. Okay. So the Taylor plate, they have, you know, cells, you know, different cells, and they have named these as, you know, Taylor's workshop or Taylor's. The name of the building is also, you know, F.W. Taylor building, like that it is in the memory of these scientists. And so he is called as the father of the scientific management. Most important, you know, line is regarded as the father of the scientific management, and he was one of the first management consultants. So he introduced, you know, method study, time study, or how to do work scientifically. So his contribution are quite great, and he is called as father of scientific management. One of the question in MCQ, because it is well known, there is nobody, no other scientist who is called as father of scientific management. So what is scientific management? It is the art of knowing what exactly you want from your employees, and how it can be done in the best possible manner. So it is nothing but application of technology, that is, you are applying the technology to manage the people. Okay, so what was the management theory by Taylor? That is, he analyzed what are the steps. That is, first is analyzing the work, okay, then developing the time and motion study. You have to remember that it is not time and motion study, it is motion and time study. Okay, first is motion or method, and then time study. First you should have, again and again telling, first you should have method to do, and once you have method which is optimum, okay, then only you can do the time study. If the method is not told, you know, that you have to do, see, you are the supervisor, you are the engineer, you have to tell the people in which best way it can be done, you know, and then only you can do the time study. Then it is breaking of a job, like particularly suppose if you want to assemble a pen and a cap, okay, so what are the different method or what are the different motions? So he will take a barrel, then he will take the bottom cap, then he will insert the refill in that, okay, then he'll put the top portion which is having inside threading on the barrel, and then finally it will put a, he'll put a cap, okay, so like that. Okay, now motion study is like he's sitting on a table, okay, and then how he's picking up the barrel, how he's picking up the cap, how he's picking up the refills, how he's placing, what are the different movements involved, and you have a technique which is called as the PMTS, that is predetermined motion and time study. Okay, so that gives, this is a mathematical technique which gives you exact time. Okay, so first you have devised a method study, that means you have told, you have made your SOP. In SOP you have written clearly the steps or the guidelines to do the particular job, that first you have to take barrel, you have to lift the barrel with the left hand, then you have to put a bottom cap, then you have to put a refill. The sequence has been defined. Okay, then one way is that you stand there in front of the employee, take a stopwatch and do the time study, like for 10 jobs and this thing. Then what happened, you know, is during this time study, first thing is that the people's are, that is, employees are resistant, because they will know, अरे ये तो बंदा अभी कल का बच्चा है और मेरा टाइम स्टडी ले रहा है, बराबर है. सो ही विल पर्पजली ही विल गो स्लो, ओके, पर्पजली लिटिल बिट स्लो, ओके, और ही विल कीप ऑन क्रिएटिंग सम प्रॉब्लम्स, लाइक सपोज टर्निंग हो रहा है, ओके, सो ही विल पर्पजली से अरे टूल ब्लंट हो गया, जॉब ट्रू नहीं हो रहा है, लाइक दैट. Okay, another thing is there will be some kind of union issues will also come. So here when you are doing the time study, you have to take average worker, means not too high skilled or not too fresh, you know, low skilled, because if you are taking high skilled person, this is what is being told by these peoples, that is this Taylor etc., and also, you know, agreed by union, because if you take a very high skilled person, then he is going to do work fatafat. If he is going to take a very low skilled person, then he will take a lot of time. So that's why we have to take an average person who is called as a representative worker or representative employee. Now we don't call worker as a worker, we call as an employee, he is a stakeholder. Okay, so we take a representative person who is representing on behalf of the all peoples who are working on the shop floor. Okay, then there will be a production supervisor, production management, and a representative employee or a worker, and also somebody, one or two people from union, because whatever time study is being done, whether it is acceptable or not, so then there will be a time study engineer. So like that, there will be 4-5 people. So, and that's why the person who is doing the work will be he will be also under tension. Then once this time study of this 10 jobs is done, then it is averaged out, okay, and then it is approved, then union leader, then representative worker and production manager will sign. Okay, so this particular job is taking say 3 minutes. That means management wants 60 divided by 3, so 20 jobs in a 1 hour. So 8 hours may management want 160 job, okay, like that. Agreement will be done, okay, and some sort of a incentive will be given. Of course not 8 hours, again we are going to study this, that what is the personal allowance, lunch allowance, all these factors come. Okay, so time study was done for almost 20-30 years. Then because of I told you that union person has to be there, worker, they don't work properly, so that's why this PMTS came into picture. So sitting on a table offline, you can calculate the time required for doing a particular task, offline mathematically. So that comes under PMTS. That also gradually you learn. So what is important, that you have to break your the job. Break the job matlab todne ka nahi job ko, nahi to bolega wo shaft jo lathe machine ke upar laga usko break karo, means the task which has to be performed, that has to be broken down into small elements, okay, and this is called as the thirblings. Again MCQ question, this is called as the thirblings, okay, and then we record down or we calculate the time for each and every thirblings, and then finally we add it, okay. This is what is theory by Taylor, okay. Okay, so these are the principles. This is again a question, theory questions, that tell us principles of management. What are the principles of management? It's four principles of management is development of a true science or technology. Then you have to select the workman properly, as I told, a representative worker. Then that representative worker, we have to see whether it is trained, whether he has proper education and number of years of experience is proper or not. So which is called as the scientific education and development of the workman. We cannot take a fresher, we cannot take too skilled person, okay. And then there has to be a proper cooperation between the management and the employee. That is what is important, right? All right, so he created a planning department, Taylor created, and gave them the responsibility to develop the scientific methods, then establish goals for productivity, then there has to be reward system, incentive system, then people has to be trained. So this is all was done by the Taylor. Okay, so four principles of the management are this. That is development of the technology, selection, then education, training, and a cooperative environment. Okay, then you have Gilbert. Okay, Gilbert contribution after Taylor. So Gilbert contribution was mostly for the time and motion. Okay, as I told, thirblings is nothing but a very small elements. Like suppose if you want to assemble stapler, okay, so what you will do if you want to assemble a pen, or if you want to assemble a small toy, or if you want to assemble a thermos flask, or a lunch box, or if you want to assemble electrical, lunch box. So what is the sequence? What are the different elements? So that is what is called the thirblings. Okay. And these thirblings, like suppose lifting a barrel. Okay. So how to lift the barrel? I am talking about pen ka barrel, जो अपना बॉल पेन रहता है ना, उस जिस और जिसके अंदर वो रिफिल बैठता है, that is called the barrel. Okay, so if you want to lift a barrel, okay, so how to lift the barrel? Where the bin should be? Whether the person is right-handed or left-handed? Okay, so depending upon that, you can divide that lifting of the barrel into further 16, maximum 16 actions. Actually, even 3 to 4 actions are enough. But if it is too complicated, like suppose if you want to lift a workpiece which is lying on the floor, and if you want to keep it on a table, okay, so you have to divide that also. Jaisa hum log slow-mo bolte hai na, slow-mo, if you are taking hum log mobile ke upar karte, so how you will lift, okay. What should be the height of the person? Okay, where the workpiece is, how much is the weight, how much he has to bend, whether he has to bend in the back or whether he has to bend in the knee, how much he has to lift, then how much he has to turn to keep it on a table. Okay, so all this distance, etc., all this lifting, that is lifting of the workpiece from the floor and placing it on the table, can be divided into maximum 16 actions. Okay, fine. If you have any doubt, you please ask. So what is management? It is nothing but coordinating work activities so that they are completed efficiently and effectively with and through other people. So see, management, manager, you do not be too technically efficient. Okay, but you should know what is what. You should know what is lathe. You should know what is tool. Chak kya hai wagara, wo sab malum hona hai. If you are technologically strong, then you can manage confidently and better. So that's why we always say that you should be technically good. Otherwise, people can fool you. Okay, but definitely a good manager knows how to tackle the things. Okay. So efficiency, that is, I always tell you that most output from least input, and effectiveness is nothing but completing activities so that the organization's goals are attained, that is targets. Now, finally, you are responsible for target. Whatever, na? Oh, manager bolta hai na, good manager. मेरे को आता नहीं है, मेरे को कुछ मालूम नहीं, मेरे को इतना ही मालूम है कि 8 घंटे में 100 पीस बनना है. वो कैसा करने का, क्या करने का, यू टेल मी व्हाट फैसिलिटीज यू वांट, यू टेल मी, आई विल प्रोवाइड दैट. ओके, सो इट इज योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. आई वांट 100 पीसेस, दिस इज माय बजट इज, ओके, विद इन दिस यू हैव टू प्रोड्यूस दिस, इफ नॉट पॉसिबल लीव, गो आउट, दिस इज व्हाट यू नो टुडे स्कीन इज. नहीं होता है तो आई विल ब्रिंग सम, because he knows, the manager knows, if you are not able to do, there is somebody who is going to do it. Understand, no? When he has some alternative, then only he can speak like that. If it doesn't have alternative, then he cannot dictate his terms. Like, he knows that this particular job, it can be done by Mr. X only. He only had that, you know, like some needs very acute skills. So if the manager knows he only this fellow can do it, I don't have alternative, then he cannot be, you know, he cannot be dictator, I said. So for that, he will always look for alternative, and then only he will dictate. Because a good manager always think, agar kar abhi main isko kuch bola aur wo chhod ke gaya, so I cannot get my target. So first he will see what is the alternative, what is the replacement. He will try to develop one more person, he will train that person, and when he is competent, then only he can dictate. Okay, then you have Fayol. So first is your Taylor, then Gilbert, and then Fayol manager. This is actually a 10 marks questions, you know. Explain the contributions of different scientists, or explain the contributions of Taylor, Gilbert, Fayol. So he came with 5 basic functions of management, that is planning. You have to plan. If you bolte na, if you don't plan, then you plan to fail karke. Then organizing, okay, then staffing, then directing, communicating, and controlling. So he first wrote that the management is a set of principles which can be learned. Okay, and he developed the 14 principles of the management file, which were very popular. Okay, so of course you did not have to go that much in details, 14 principles, because earlier it was industrial engineering was a separate, you know, subject itself, but now it is clubbed with HRM, clubbed with ergonomics, so that's why we don't go much in detail. So what are the management functions? So 5 types of functions. They are planning, okay, organize, you have to organize it, then you have to people recruit the people, you have to train them, then leadership is very important, leader has to be there. Okay, and then control. Okay, so see, monitoring and controlling is the most important function anywhere you go, and it is applicable everywhere. Monitor and control, okay, whether you are a student or whether you are a chairman, okay. Monitoring and controlling is important. That is, you have to monitor what you are doing and you have to control what you are doing in order to complete the task. Like I want to do MS, okay, so I am monitoring what I have to do. So second year mein what I have to do, third year mein I have to go for the classes, I have to attend for the GREs, exams, etc. Then final year mein I have to do the communications with the people, okay. And simultaneously you have to control also, okay, that whether you are on the track or not, okay. So what has been planned has been going as per the planning or not, okay. So this east five principles or this this process functions is really you know important, that everybody should understand and should work accordingly. So even ISO that is International Standard Organization also gives important to this monitoring and controlling. And in again in ISO there is something called as the identification, okay, like you can identify if something goes wrong, you know. So there is something called as the identification and traceability. Like suppose if you receive a defective piece, or suppose in service or in use if something is not functioning properly, okay, then you can identify and you can trace why it has happened, why that defective piece has come, you know, into the use. And you can trace right from its birth, means right from its raw material supplies. Who has machined it? Who has made it? Who has supplied the raw material? How the raw material, whether the heat treatment was done or not. So this is the purpose of actually documentation. Sometimes we say that ISO is a kya ISO about documentation, but it is really a good technique. The first purpose is that you can identify, this is very strong tool, it you can identify and trace if something goes wrong, okay. And of course if your system is proper, it will not allow you to go wrong, okay. And second thing is, if nobody is there, if your systems are there, then the show can be run. That is the most important advantage. You don't have to have peoples around, supervisor, manager, etc. If you have proper system, then show can run as per the defined, as per the SOPs, okay. Person knows what I have to do, SOP is written, he knows what job is to be taken, he knows from where to collect the material, material is here, tools, etc. So it can be run, and that is what the achievement of an engineer is, okay. Normally we say ki are main nahi rahega to kaam nahi hona mangta hai, okay, but this is wrong, okay. Agar main nahi hai fir bhi kaam hona hai, and that is what is people will remember for you for this purpose. If you are not there, but still it should function, and that is what is your success is. Understand, you are meant for development purpose. Engineers are meant for development work, understand, and not for the routine work. You have to set, you have to implement the systems, okay. And this is what exactly we learn in industrial engineering, okay. So the 14 principles of management is specialization of the labor, okay. That is, you continuously train, okay. Then authority, okay, this is most important, okay. You should delegate the authority, okay. If like suppose if you are a production manager and if you don't have any authorities, you know, you cannot get the work done. Who is going to respect you? वर्कर बोलेगा अरे इसके हाथ में कुछ नहीं है, ये अपना कुछ बिगाड़ नहीं सकता है, हाँ उसका क्या सुनने का, जाने दो, ऐसा रहता है. सो यू शुड हैव अथॉरिटीज, नो डाउट यू शुड हैव रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज, बट यू कैनॉट परफॉर्म और यू कैनॉट एग्जीक्यूट योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज अनलेस एंड अंटिल योर अथॉरिटी. Simple example, like suppose if you are not authorized to sign the leave or to sanction the leave, ek worker aaya, saab mereko kal chutti chahiye, okay, मेरा ये लीव फॉर्म सही करो। इफ इसे अरे मेरे पास तो अथॉरिटी नहीं है, आप मैनेजर के पास जाओ। ओके दूसरा जन आया साहब मेरे को जल्दी जाने का है, एक घंटा मेरे को छोड़ दो करके। अगेन यू विल से ये जो शॉर्टलिस्ट है शॉर्ट लीव है, आई एम नॉट ऑथराइज गो टू मैनेजर। तीसरा जन आया सर कल मेरे को आधा घंटा लेट होएगा, ओके सो मैं अभी लेट फॉर्म भर के जाता हूँ करके। तुम बोलेगा नहीं मैनेजर को इन्फॉर्म करो। सो व्हाई फोर्थ पर्सन विल लिसन टू यू? वो बोलेगा अरे हम लोग आते हैं आप बोलते हैं मैनेजर के पास, तो आप काम ही हमको दे दो, दो ना। आस्क मैनेजर टू अलोकेट अलॉट टू वर्क टू अस, विल लिसन टू द मैनेजर ओनली। सो दैट्स व्हाई यू नो दिस अथॉरिटी इज इम्पोर्टेंट। वर्कर को मालूम है अरे मैं काम नहीं करेगा बराबर बिहेव नहीं करेगा तो ये मेरे को मेरा लीव अटका देगा, ही विल नॉट सैंक्शन दैट लीव। ओके सो दैट अथॉरिटी हैज टू बी देयर यू नो। जो पेटी कैश, अगर आप यू डोंट हैव अथॉरिटी टू साइन द चेक और टू गिव द पेटी कैश, देन हु इज गोइंग टू लिसन ना परचेस मैन। सो डिसिप्लिन, सो दिस इज व्हाट इज योर अथॉरिटी, देन डिसिप्लिन इज अगेन मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट। ओके यू शुड नॉट स्लैक द रूल्स और यू शुड नॉट बेंड द रूल्स, यू हैव टू स्ट्रिक्टली एडर टू द सेट रूल्स। देन it is a line management, that is each employee will have one boss only, one immediate, he cannot listen to the four five people. ek aadmi hai wo ek ka hi sunega, usko panch jan aake sune are ye karo, dusra aayega nahi ye karo, tisra aayega are aisa mat karo, so he'll get confused. Okay so he has to receive the instruction only from one person, right? Unity of direction, a single mind generates a single plan and all play their part in that plan. Subordination of individual interests, when at work only work things should be pursued or thought about, kuch personal nahi karne ke. Remuneration should be proper, fair, understand, because everybody work for the money, right? So the money is most important. Then centralization, consideration of, I'll just take 2 minutes, centralization of management functions, decisions, they are made from the top. Charity begins at the top, all right? Then there has to be a line of authority, like purchase department mein kaisa rehta hai ki, yes, jo general manager purchase hai, he has authority to sign a check of 1 crore or maybe 50 lakhs. Uske niche ka hai, he'll have authority for 10 lakhs. Then jo purchase engineers hai, like you freshers, when you join purchase department, you cannot sign, you know, you are not authorized to sign a check of 50 lakhs or 10 lakhs, but up to certain amount, like 5,000, 10,000, you can sanction. Okay, you every now you don't have to go to the run to the purchase manager, sir, Mr. sign for up to 5,000, you can take the decision and you can sanction it. Okay, then order, this we are going to learn in 5 years. Okay, all materials and personnel, they have a place, everything in its place, everything has a place, everything in its place. Equity, should not be biased, should not be fair to some people, unfair to others. So equality of the treatment. Then personal tenure, that is limited turnover of personnel, this is what is very important, because that improves your image and productivity. Aaj aaya kal gaya, so like that, are you going to train each and everyone every day? Is it going to be a training institute? No. Initiative, okay, this is very important. Initiative, if you don't have initiative, you cannot develop. Okay, then harmony, cohesion among the personnel, that is a spirit, D corps. So this is the principle, that in union there is a strength. Be united and stay united, that is the principle. Okay, so we'll continue this in the next class. If you have any doubt, you can please ask, otherwise we'll call it a day. Thank you. Any doubts? Okay, fine.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you.